أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear sweet brothers, dear sisters, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. We just finished our salah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it in your hasanat and accept it from all of us. Ameen, ya arhamar rahimeen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the children and the sons of Adam. We've been honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything and subjugated for us to use it, not to misuse it. And the plus also to get the benefit out of that. Everything being created for you. But you are a special creature in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your father Adam being created by the hand of Allah, first of all. Second, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admitted him in Jannah. He was in Jannah. Before that, he gave orders to al-Malaika to bow to him. See how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored him. And he is, subhanallah, examining us and he's preparing Jannah for our final destination for the mu'minin, inshallah. May Allah make us amongst them, inshallah. Amen, ya Rabbi, ameen. For that's why Islam, even when he sent the revelation or his system and law through his manhaj, the Quran al-Kareem and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Azza wa Jalla al-Shari' al-Hakim, he cares about you. And he said, من مقاصد الشريعة الخمسة, the main purpose of our Sharia, Islam, to guard your mind. Don't use drugs and eat something can harm you or to you can lose your mind. And to guard your body, you have to be healthy as much as you can. And to guard your honor, your ird, your honor. And to guard your deen, to guard your deen. These are the main thing of the Sharia. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran and the Sharia, his system, his law. If you follow it, it's the manual, like what I said. If you follow it, that's good for your maintenance. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one he created you, and he knows how to maintain you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-ulama, they talk a lot about that. That's why Islam forbids us from what? Shedding blood, killing someone, destroying the body of someone, because they call it, it's a name, or the Islam call it killing. It's killing, it's not death, normal death. Normal death they call al-wafa. And al-wafa yatawafakum means when you will be fully get your time in this dunya, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you rizq in full, or time in full, and that's why al-khal yatawafakum, you take it in full, khalas, you have nothing in this dunya. It's called al-wafa. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused you to die while even you're sitting in your house or sleeping in your bed peacefully. He honored you when you comes and he honored you when you go. But if somebody is destroying your body or shedding blood or killing you or threatening you, this is against the Sharia of Islam, to kill people and to shed blood and to destroy their life. That's why the one who's killing a mu'min, Khalid, subhanAllah, intentionally, he will be in Jahannam forever, for eternity. Because who are you? Did you create this person to destroy him? Why you destroy him? Are you the one who created him? Huh? For that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this is one of the major, major, major signs, killing people. It's not good. In Islam, يعني, subhanAllah, we have three categories. What about my little khatra today? Fajr time. Islam يعني, commanded us to abstain from these three categories. قال, one of these categories, to revive your soul and to improve your bodies, such as forbidding killing, as just said right now, and also eating impurities. Subhanallah, akal khabath, anything impure, you're not supposed to eat it. Khabith, something not filthy, something is not pure. Forbidding killing or eating impurities and the poisons also. You cannot poison yourself. You cannot kill yourself. Islam forbids others to attack you and to kill your body, and also you cannot do that yourself too. Even the scholar, they have details in that. يعني, subhanAllah, Islam forbids the salihin to pray janaza for the one who kills himself. General people can kill him and go bury him like this. Like the way Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم told Ali ibn Abi Talib, go worry your dad. Go, يعني, bury your dad. خلاص. إذا فوري أباك يعني. Go bury him. خلاص. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he did not pray for him. He did not do anything because he knows he's kafir, Abu Talib. سبحان الله. And the Rasulullah was sad because of that. Said, إنك لا تهد من أحببت ولكن الله يهدي من يشاء. It's not, the guidance is not in your hand, يا رسول الله. فالإسلام forbids us from killing ourselves, harming ourselves, or harming others, eating impurities, and also poisons, and drinking alcohol. We've been forbidden. It's a haram. It's a major sin. That leads to what? Corruption and demise of mind, of the mind. That's why, subhanAllah, Islam cares about that. Also, Islam forbids us also from being angry, الغضب, subhanAllah, and hatred, and to be unjust or extravagance that leads to hatred, subhanAllah. People, Islam forbids us from that too. You have to be good to each other, cool as much as you can. Before you do anything, you have to think. Even Islam forbids us to appoint your brother with little knife or even with your finger like this. If you want to appoint to somebody with all of your hand like that. He said, your finger like this, this is not in Islam. Yeah, did I tell you? Like this? This is not good. Even hadida. Hadida like anything. If you have even screwdriver, don't do it like this. Or knife or anything. You see somebody, when he became angry, he can throw it to somebody, can, it comes to his eyes or his heart and you kill him. So I did not mean it. But Rasulullah said, عَلَى قَرْنَهَا شَيْطَان. In the top of it, shaitan. That's why be careful. Don't be angry. And that sahabi said, ya Rasulullah, give me advice. He said, don't be angry. He said, I know this. Again, the Rasulullah said, don't be angry. The third time he said, ya Rasulullah, give me advice. He said, I told you, don't be angry and you will go to Jannah. Might be Rasulullah, he knows that man is kharban. And he just pushed his button and he became like fire. That's why he said, don't be angry, control yourself. And they said, ليس الشديد بالسرعة ولكن الشديد الذي يملك نفسه عند الغضب. The strong amongst you, not the one who's wrestling people, but the strong amongst you, the one who's controlling himself during his time of anger. This is the shadid, the strong one. This is what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said. More you will be angry, more you can do whatever you want. You can kill people just blindly. And Islam forbids us also from doing haram like zina. Why? Or nikah al-maharim like what this is akhfazun nowadays. Why? Because Islam wanted us to live in a very peaceful and clean society. Imagine if this society is very dirty like what we see nowadays. You see zina al-maharim. Somebody is making zina with his mother, with his daughter. Yeah, in the social media. With his aunt, with his sakhfara azim arab, with his mother-in-law. Yes, we see all of his stories in the social media. Zin al-maharim, this is the worst. She's mahram for you, you're not supposed to touch your daughter. And instead of guarding her, he's making zina with her. And getting the child, and both of them, they killed the child. Lack of knowledge, lack of iman, stupidity. Kuffar Quraysh, they never make this. Kuffar Quraysh, they never make this. And they are Muslims and they are making zina maharim. See, a man is making zina with his daughter. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. And instead of guarding her, you are her guardian. Ya Ahmar. تعمل كده مصيبة. مصيبة. والله مصيبة. يعني that's why he forbids us in Islam from zina. And Islam said you have to honor yourself. Don't make zina al-maharim. Also, subhanAllah, he said, فكانت نعمته فيما حضره علينا كنعمته فيما أباحه لنا. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids us and abstains us from any kind of haram, it's a ni'mah, it's a favor from Allah, out of His grace, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the same ni'mah from Allah, favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is favoring us when he order you and command you to do certain things. That's why the main point of Islam, افعل ولا تفعل, do and don't. That's it. افعل, this is good. And this mostly comes in the ayat al-madaniya and the madani chapters. And more than 88 times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving a call to the believing men and women in the Quran. And he said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا. عبد الله بن مسعود he said that when you see يا أيها الذين آمنوا in the Quran, mostly this is Madani Surah. Means Allah gonna tell you do something which is good for you, or is abstaining you from doing something this is bad for you. Be away from that. This is exactly all يا أيها الذين آمنوا in the Quran. All you who believed, the believing men. Allah is calling the مؤمنين. عبد الله بن مسعود said when you hear this or you read it, قال استرع انتباهك واسمع واسمعوا وعوا. You have to pay attention and listen carefully because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling you. يا أيها الذين آمنوا. ها؟ سبحان أطيعوا الله والرسول مثلا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقربوا الصلاة وأنتم كذا. يا الذين آمنوا إنما الخمر والميسر والأنصاب والأزلام رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوه. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم. Either he's ordering you to do something is good for you. The result of it is good for you in the end, the fruits of it. Or he said, be away from this, but this is not, that's good for you. Don't eat al-khanzir, swan, the pork, and don't drink al-khamr, don't make adultery, zina. And all al-asl fi al-ashiyah al-ibaha. In Islam, everything is mubah, halal for you. Everything in Islam is halal for you. Eating, drinking, clothing. Except whatever Allah makes it haram. Maybe like 7 to 8 things. All haram forbidden, the rest is halal, enjoy. You don't need fatwa from Sayyid Jum'ah anymore. خلاص. Yeah. استفتي قلبك وقل أفتوك أفتو. أذكر أرض. Everything is halal except whatever Allah and the Rasul said it in the authentic sunnah. It's haram. For example, gold is haram for men. Why are you wearing gold? It's haram for a man, but halal for women. To wear silk, haram for men, but it's halal for women. See? فأم telling you, there is something halal, there is something haram. So that's why we have to be, inshallah, careful of that. And there is a gray area between halal and the haram. When you will be in the gray area, leave it. Get out of the shubha. عشان ومن حام حول الحمى يوشك أن يواقعه. The gray area. If you see the gray area, halal ولا حرام يا شيخ, leave it. I don't need it, يا عم. بس وخلاص أيوه بالظبط. فأمسك الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين يتقبل منا وإياكم صالح الأعمال وأن يرحمنا ويسترنا ويجبرنا وأن يفقهنا في ديننا وأن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وينفعنا بما علمنا. أسك الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أرحم الراحمين أن يسترنا وإياكم في الدنيا والآخرة ويحفظنا وإياكم يا رب العالمين. واشف من كان منا مريضا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين يا ربنا. يسر أمورنا يا من كتابنا واحفظنا جميعا وإياكم من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمالنا واجعل لك يا ربنا من الشاكرين. وانصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين وأعلم فضلك لما الحق والدين وانصر المستضعفين من المسلمين في كل مكان يا أرحم الراحمين. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا.